At the beginning of this topic, I made some generalizations about nucleophiles and about leaving groups. If you remember about leaving groups, what I said was that there's a lot of different types, but the most common is alkyl halides, right? And that's what we've been using this entire topic. Another generalization I made was with nucleophiles, when I said that just think that a negatively charged nucleophile is strong and a neutral one is weak. And I just said, let's just say that for now, okay? What I want to do for this topic is go more in depth on leaving groups and nucleophiles so that we can really understand like all the different types instead of and all the different types of strengths instead of just making generalizations, all right? So, let's get started with the leaving groups first, okay? As I said before, alkyl halides are the most common leaving groups of organic chemistry. So, 90% of the time, you're just going to see alkyl halides. And that's why we've been dealing with them so much, because they literally are so ubiquitous, all right? They're everywhere. But it turns out that there's other types of leaving groups as well. Another really common one being sulfonate esters, okay? Now, these don't show up as often as alkyl halides, but they do show up a good amount. What a sulfonate ester is it's a molecule with the general formula SO3R, okay? Now, typically, we wouldn't, and this is actually the way it looks, by the way. The sulfonate ester general structure is that you have your chain. Let's say this is my chain here. Okay, and let's say that this is attached, and it's going to be an O with then an S and two O's and then an R. Now, typically, would we expect O to be a good leaving group? No. Remember that O is not as electronegative as an alkyl halide. It's actually, you know, further this way. So we would expect that O would not be a good leaving group, and O negative would suck. But this molecule is special because it can resonate so much, okay? And I did talk about this earlier when we were talking about leaving groups, that we could, once I get a negative charge there, this would be able to resonate and make double bonds and distribute that negative charge everywhere. So sulfonate esters turn out to be really, really good leaving groups, even better than alkyl halides in some cases, because they have so much resonance available, so it's going to stabilize the leaving group just like a conjugate base would be stabilized by the resonance effect. Okay? Remember that parallel that I drew between conjugate bases and leaving groups? It's the same thing. So it turns out that the sulfonate ester, you might just see it drawn as SO3R, in which case you need to know what that is, okay? You also might have seen it drawn OSO2R, same thing, okay? That's just the way it's actually drawn out. There's an O first, okay? You need to be able to recognize that that's a leaving group. But on top of that, like, you could see a special type of sulfonate ester. It turns out sulfonate ester is the general category, but there's actually three unique types of sulfonate esters, okay? And those are tosylates, mesylates, and triflates, okay? Now, the difference between those three actually just has to do with the R group, okay? So everything else is the same. The S is the same, the O's are the same, everything. The only thing that changes is the identity of the R group. So let's go really quickly into that, okay? If that R group is just a methyl group, which is this middle situation, that's going to be called a mesylate. Or a mesyl group or a mesylate, once it has the negative charge, and it's abbreviated MS, okay? So if you see that, you know it's a sulfonate ester. How about if it's a benzene ring with a methyl group on it? If it's a benzene ring with a methyl group, that's going to be called a tosylate, and that's abbreviated TS. And then if it's a C with three Fs instead of three Hs, then that's called a triflyl or a triflate, if it has once it has the negative charge, okay? Now, I know you guys may be wondering, when do I use like the word tosyl, when do I use tosylate? The ending 8 just means that there's a negative charge. And that's common throughout lots of chemistry. We say in Orgo 2 we use it a lot more, that naming system. It just means if you have an 8 at the end, it just means you have a negative anion. Alright? So anyway, the whole point here is I don't need you to memorize exactly each sulfonate ester, okay? I don't want you to be able to draw it if I give it to you. But what I do want you to be able to do is recognize that if you see these weird letters like OTS or OMS or whatever, that you're going to know, hey, that this is a sulfonate ester, so it's a really good leaving group, okay? Now, I did notice one little error here. This should have been OMS, not OTS. So I'm gonna change that. But anyway, you guys get the whole point that basically, if you see one of these things, consider it the same as an alkyl halide, okay? So if there's an RX, it's the same thing as an OMS or whatever, all right? So that's the first leaving group that I want to tell you guys about. It's important. don't pay too much attention to it. Just treat it the same as you would an alkyl halide, all right? So if I see a secondary mesylate, that's the same thing as a secondary iodine or whatever. The next one that I want to talk about is water. So water is actually a pretty common leaving group that we're going to use in a little bit. We haven't used it yet. But the way that we do it, the way we get water as a leaving group, is to protonate alcohol with a strong acid, okay? So what you'll notice here is I have alcohol. Is alcohol typically a good leaving group? No. Typically it sucks, because once I kick off that O, what I'm going to get is OH minus, and that's very unstable. That's actually a really strong base. So that's not a good leaving group. But if I can protonate the alcohol first with a strong acid, like for example, sulfuric acid, which is a really common one that's used, then it's going to leave as water. Let me show you. So if the first step is, let's use an easier one. Let's just use HCl, okay? If my first step is to expose the alcohol to my strong acid, guess what's going to happen? My alcohol is going to grab the H, and it's going to become protonated. Once it's protonated, it looks like this, OH2 positive. That's not very happy the way it is, because it has a formal charge now. So now, guess what can happen in the next step? It can leave all on its own, just like an alkyl halide would in a mechanism. And then what you're going to get is, you're going to get, let's say, a carbocation, if this is an SN1 reaction or an E1, plus water. Is water a good leaving group? Is it stable? Yeah, it's super stable because it's just neutral. All right. So see that by protonating my alcohol first, I could turn it from a bad leaving group to actually a really good leaving group. So now you guys know overall general idea here. Alkyl halides are the most important. You're going to see them all the time. If you see a sulfonate ester, it's going to be one of these weird letters. Don't worry about it too much. Just treat it the same as an alkyl halide. If you see water with a strong acid, treat it the same way as an alkyl halide. The whole point is just that it leaves. That's the end goal. I don't want you guys to get mixed up by all this. All right? These are really the three main ones that we see. We don't see a whole lot of others. So don't worry about anything else as a leaving group except these three categories.